Well, here it is, a couple days after the blizzard. It's been crazy weather here. I mean, Tuesday, it was in the 40s. Wednesday, we got a massive blizzard, probably the worst snowstorm of the season. I mean, you can look, you can see it's just, look at how deep this stuff is. And we got like 10 to 15 inches of snow, high winds, crazy, crazy day. There was a blizzard. And yesterday, it was a high of 12 degrees and around zero at night. Then today, it's been above 50. So, hey, go figure. This is March, and especially here in Western New York. But as confusing as all that is, and such a tease, you know, you get a nice day, then you get a crappy day. This kind of made my day today. I went to the post office early this morning, and the lady, without even me going up to the counter, had these waiting for me. Because she says, you got more rocks. And that was music to my ears, of course. And I got a couple packages here. One's from Tavis, a friend of mine down in Pennsylvania. And the other one is from a guy that's a pretty talented little leather worker. You know, he does brain tan. He does a lot of cool stuff, from Nick Fuller. And Nick, thanks a whole bunch for what you did here. And Tavis, thanks for sending this. So let's take a peek here. I this was all wrapped up in newspaper, and I wanted to save time. But look at this box of rocks. Isn't that a beautiful sight? I mean, really. You know, I love Navaculite. That's cool stuff. And there's a mix of things. There's some challenges in here now. A piece like this is really challenging because it's so thick. Let me go turn down my scanner, because that's going to make all kinds of noise here while I try to talk to you. There we go. Much nicer. So, yeah, look at all this rock in here. I mean, there's some dacite here. That's what this is. Dacite's always a great stone to work with. And a couple. And some more Texas here. This piece looks tough. And sometimes it can fool you. You know, it can look really dry and tough and be the nicest stuff to work. And, you know, all the way down through the box is some goodies. So, I can't thank you enough, and I know you want a hardened point, and that's what I'll strive to get out of this, and hopefully something else. It's going to be a little bit, because, like I say, I'm kind of buried here. Even old Boney here is standing up to his chest in snow. This is ridiculous. So, really thrilled to have that. This was very unexpected here. Check out the goodies in here. A really nice note in here. But look at the work. Don't you just love seeing something like that when you open a box? I mean, that just makes my heart race. Love it. Absolutely love what I'm seeing here. Got some hides, and he told me that he egg tanned these squirrels. To me, that's the best squirrel. It's a hide. Little buggers are always after my bird seed out here. He did a great job tanning these. They're nice and soft. And about the only useful thing of a squirrel is his hide. There's another one, too. Check this. That's a big squirrel. Very impressive. But it just keeps getting better and better. Look at these brain tan leather bags. Man, these things are sweet with the big fringe on them. Love the smell. And it's extremely well done. I know Tribe of Benjamin would really like to see these, because this is what he does. Plus it's got a, you know, it's got a string. I can hang these right here in the man cave, or hang them off my backpack, whatever. There's another really super nice one, and with the braided cord here. Look at this guy. Awesome. But this was the one that really blew me away, was this great big one here. Look at this. That's a lot of brain tan to make a bag like that. The cool part is, I love what he fastened the catch with here. With a round here. Looks to be a 280. That's a great idea for the flap. And I know there's something in here. I'm not sure what it is. Oh, very, very, very cool. I'm thrilled. This is man cave stuff. And that is a Genesee point. That's what I'm famous for making. Look at that. Now, you'll probably see this in future videos, because it's going to be living out here in the man cave. Hopefully the man cave doesn't fall down and I got to dig it out to find it. But that is really cool. But this great bag here. Great bag. Then to top it all off, down here in the bottom, big old bag of rock. And I don't know what there is for sure, but I think it's all from his state. So anyway, I think my camera shut off. I'm back. At the bottom of that one box was a big bag. Some beautiful heat-treated rock from his area. Looks a little dry, but you know, when they're heat treated, a lot of times they do look dry on the outside, and then when you start chipping them, they turn right to glass. So I can't wait to give that a try. Might be a little while with all this, and before we get it all gone and I get some regular nice warm temperatures. But just I want to thank both you guys for this, being so generous and making my day. I'm telling you, with the way things are going here lately, you know, with all the weather changes and my wife having the broken leg and all that. She's doing good, by the way. Took her for physical therapy today. And she's ahead of the game. She's completely healed. She can walk. Surgeon did a great job. So anyway, I'll be back with more once I get some warm weather here and able to do a little more chipping. So thanks, guys. Thanks for everyone that watches. Take care.